Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today we're going to be doing a test on my compressor here. In the past, when I plug it in the garage, it will trip the breaker, but if I hook it up to the generator here, it fills up the tank, shuts itself off, and will operate normally. So what I'm doing today is, first we're going to show that it will operate normally hooked up to the generator, and then I'm going to go in the house, change the circuit breaker to the same size circuit breaker, because you never want to up the amperage on a circuit breaker that the circuit is not designed for. So it was a 15 amp breaker in there before. I'm going to put a 15 amp breaker in there now when we change it out, and we'll see if that takes care of our problem. So let's get started. Here are the specs. I don't know if this helps you at all, or what that even says on that tag. And same with the motor. So there's some info on the motor. All right, I'm gonna start up the generator, then plug the compressor into it, flip the switch, and see if it'll fill the tank on the compressor with ease. So the generator only has electric start, and since I don't properly maintain that battery like I should, I'm going to be using my Sinter jumper pack mini, and put a link in the description or a link up at the top here. If you want to check out, I've got a couple videos on that there, and there may be a link in the description if you're interested in one, but I'm going to jump start the generator with this now. The battery is on the back side of the generator, so that's where I have to go to jump start it. And these gauges aren't the clearest to read, but it looks like we're outlet pressure says around 100. And tank pressure says 100. So let's just test out the nozzle real quick. All right, so. Should block most of the wind noise, but you could clearly hear that it's got air in there. And now we're just going to empty the tank, and we're going to try it again in the garage on the house power until it trips the breaker or fills the tank. But I suspect it's going to trip the breaker because that's what it's been doing in years past. And also with my Campbell Hausfeld compressor, did the same thing, but Campbell Hausfeld's in the shed and Speed Air is in the garage, so we're testing today with the Speed Air. So let's empty this tank and then try to refill it with the house power. All right, so I completely drained the tank. Show you the gauges here. Hopefully you can read them. It's at zero. So the stem on the valve here to pump your tires is, you can push it with your bare hand and nothing will come out. So you can clearly see it's empty, and got it plugged in here inside the garage. And then we're gonna turn it on and run it until it's either full and we don't have an issue, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Or it pops the breaker, and then we'll go inside and change the circuit breaker. Yeah, that is so much quieter than the generator. Okay, I'm gonna put on the tripod here. Well, I know that it definitely popped the breaker because the lights went off in the garage. But let's check and see what the pressure got up to. So what's that look like about? It got up to 80, but it did trip the breaker. But I suppose if I dropped it down to 80, might get lucky if it'll shut off at 80 before tripping the breaker. But we're gonna shut this off and go downstairs and figure out which breaker's tripping. What do you think of the wood enclosure I built here for my panel box? Did that years ago. All right, so let's see which breaker's off. So it looks like it's the breaker at the very top right. I didn't realize, apparently when it's showing orange, even though the breaker looked like it was flipped to the left, it was tripped, and so that's the one we're gonna have to replace and see if this works. So I'm gonna do that. I'm not gonna show you how to do that because if you don't know what you're doing, I don't want you to get hurt. This could be dangerous. I know what I'm doing, but I'm not showing you how to do this part here. If you're thinking of doing this, make sure you consult a licensed electrician. So like I said, there's the old breaker, and this is the new one. Obviously it has to be the same brand. Hopefully that's what we have here, but it looks like the same one. Obviously it won't work if it's not, but let's finish this up. All right, so got the new breaker in, turned on, and the only way you could tell that it's the new one is that that one has got the new square D on it, and you can actually read the 15 amp on the throw switch. In the old one, you can't really see squat, but that's it's changed out. We'll see if it makes a difference. As you can see, the lights are back on in the garage, so that means the breaker's working and it's plugged in there. Again, like before, I never unplugged it. Compressor here at virtually. I'm gonna relieve all the pressure, I guess. Okay, so I released all the pressure. We're starting from scratch. We're gonna throw the switch. Like I said, the lights are on in the garage. So I'm gonna test this in a real world situation. Lights on in the garage and try to run the compressor. If that pops the breaker, I'll try it with the lights off just to see if there's any difference. But let's give it a shot. And like I said, I'll throw this on the tripod and maybe we'll speed up the process. Wow, so that's it. All these years, I'm gonna back it up here. It worked, so I'm gonna show you. Lights are still on the garage. It shut itself off. Just gonna throw this off because it looks like we have a little bit of a leak and I don't want it to turn back on. But here we go. It's over 100 PSI and it shut itself off. And it looks like a success. Well guys, mystery solved. All these years, I didn't even test it. I actually bought this circuit breaker last year in 2019 and then just never got around to doing it. And I said, you know what? Enough's enough. Let me do the test. Pulled out that generator to show that the compressor would actually function properly. Then I changed out that breaker after we saw it pop the old breaker, and the new breaker works. The light stayed on in the garage. It pumped it up to 100 PSI, where it popped it before at 80. And I don't have an issue. So that's all it was, an old breaker that just couldn't handle the amperage anymore. 15 amp breaker, like I said, if your circuit is designed for a 15 amp breaker, don't ever put a bigger breaker in there to try to overcome something, because you could start a fire. Consult an electrician if you're concerned about this, because it can be dangerous, but that fixed my problem. And so I want to appreciate you for watching the videos. Please give it a thumbs up if you like this video. Check the links in the description and check out some of the videos at the end of the suggestions here. Thanks for watching. Take care.